should I love God? You should love God non-mentally. That is to say, the soul should become non-mental and stripped of her mental images. For as long as your soul is mental, she will possess images. As long as she has images, she will possess intermediaries. And as long as she has intermediaries, she will not have unity or simplicity. As long as she lacks simplicity, she does not truly love God. For true love depends upon simplicity. Indeed, you must love God as He is one, pure, simple, and transparent, far from all duality. And we should eternally sink into this one, thus passing from something into nothing. Now, you might say, how can this be? I cannot feel God's presence in any way. Listen to this. Sensing God's presence is not in your power, but in that. God will show itself when it suits God to do so. And it also can remain hidden if that is God's wish. This is what Christ meant when he said to Nicodemus, "The Spirit breathes where it will. You hear its voice, but do not know where it comes from or where it is going." For God has not linked our salvation with any particular kind of devotion. Any one devotional practice has things which others lack. But the effectiveness of all good practices comes from God alone and is denied to none of them. For one form of goodness cannot conflict with another. Therefore, people should remember that if they see or hear of a good person who is following a way which is different from theirs, then they are wrong to think that such a person's efforts are all in vain. If someone else's way of devotion does not please them, then they are ignoring the goodness in it, as well as that person's good intention. This is wrong. We should see the true feeling in people's devotional practices and should not scorn the particular way that anyone follows. But where is this true possession of God, whereby we really possess God, to be found? This real possession of God is to be found in the heart, in an inner motion of the spirit towards that and striving for that. Not just in thinking about God always and in the same way, for that would be beyond the capacity of our nature and would be very difficult to achieve and would not even be the best thing to do. We should not content ourselves with the God of thoughts, for when the thoughts come to an end, so too shall God. Rather, we should have a living God who is beyond the thoughts of all people and all creatures. That kind of God will never leave us. Unless we ourselves choose to turn away from that. Now pay attention to this. God is nameless, for no one can either speak of God or know God. Therefore, a pagan master says that what we can know or say of the first cause reflects ourselves more than it does the first cause. For this transcends all speech and all understanding. God is being beyond being. God is a no-thingness beyond being. Therefore, Saint Augustine says, the finest thing that we can say of God is to be silent concerning him. From the wisdom of inner riches. Be silent, therefore, and do not chatter about God. For by chattering about God, you tell lies and commit a sin. If you wish to be perfect and without sin, then do not prattle about God. Also, you should not wish to understand anything about God, for God is beyond all understanding. A master says, if I had a God that I could understand, I would not regard that as God. If you understand anything about God, then God is not in it. And by understanding something of God, you fall into ignorance. And by falling into ignorance, you become like an animal. Since the animal part in creatures is that which is unknowing. If you do not wish to become like an animal, therefore, do not pretend that you understand anything of the ineffable God.